My name is Elisa Sicuri. I am assistant professor at ISGlobal and associate professor at the University of Barcelona, although I also have a position of researcher at Imperial College London. We mainly work in cost-effectiveness analysis of health interventions, which is quite a relevant activity in global health because it allows to combine the cost and effectiveness of the interventions and generates very relevant knowledge for policymakers in order for them to take their decisions in global health. But we are also getting better and better somehow in describing the market for health products. So drugs, vaccines, and also diagnostic tools. And this is also very relevant because it allows to stress all of the weaknesses and all of the imperfections that the market have. And this imperfection may have an impact in the access effectively to drugs and to vaccines in endemic countries. We have very recently proved that there is a risk of inequity in the access to anti-malarial drugs in MANISA. And this is due to the fact that we have seen that the price at which pharmacies, private pharmacies, sell anti-malarials is much higher than the real ability to pay of the people in the area. The main contribution we have produced so far to global health has been the fact of proving that many interventions that are really very important for the health of the people are actually cost effective and so worth to invest in. And this is the case, for instance, of malaria in pregnancy, but it's also the case of screening and treating people who are at risk of Chagas disease in non-endemic areas. The other important contribution, although this is still a work in progress, is proving the fact that a reduction in the number of cases of malaria in Mozambique can translate or could possibly translate into improved performances at school through a reduction in absenteeism at school, and the same for workers in the sugarcane factories. So if we are able to prove that actually a reduction in the number of malaria cases, potentially the elimination, of course, of the number of malaria cases, can translate into an improvement in these indicators, then we have very strong evidence on the fact that the reduction and the fight against malaria is helping the country to improve growth, economic growth and development.